2023 Nissan Frontier. With best-in-class horsepower and intelligent technology, you can haul all the things you need to go off the grid and leave basic far behind. The 2023 Nissan Frontier. Anything but basic.
At Nissan Lawton, we don't do basic. Our new car gift to you, no payment until March 2023. Happy holidays from Nissan of Lawton.
Previously on Moguls in the Making, 60 students from HBCUs all across the country gathered at the Ally headquarters to embark on a once-in-a-lifetime journey.
You're all here this weekend to take on this problem of economic mobility.
All right, so who's taking it home? Alabama State University is the best university.
Woo! Go Jay!
We've met the teams, we know their industries. The only question that remains now is, who has what it takes to win?
With a competition this high stakes, we will be absolutely foolish if we did not give these young moguls in the making some guidance 24/7. And so we have some mentors that are with them around the clock. Here's what they are seeing.
Good mentors, listening, trying not to shape the direction too much.
And someone who can relate with the individuals in a room.
Guide them when they're feeling like they're hitting some roadblocks.
To make sure that my students know that I am there for them and to hype them up.
This is a really difficult, grueling competition. They go through challenges that they may have never experienced before, and I'd like to remind them that, you know, they're here for a reason.
Ashley Pauling is our mentor, and as someone who actually lives in Charlotte, she is very necessary for our kind of authentic view of how they need help.
It's just energizing to just be in such an environment like this, and doing it for such a wonderful partners like Ally, it's beyond my wildest imaginations.
Aided with a team of their peers and a trusted industry mentor to keep them on track, the students head to their team ideation rooms and begin mapping out their business ideas.
I'm competitive, so I want us to win, right? But you're already winners because you're here, like the people said, right there on the microphone.
So, how are you feeling?
I was sure hoping for entertainment art, and I was sure trying to figure out the difference between the housing category and real estate.
Because I feel like that there could be some overlap in our ideas.
Okay. Right. Is it more consumer side or is it more investor?
I'm gonna find that out as a take.
I'm guessing consumer.
He's a great project manager, to be honest. So he's been leading us with structure, and then we just, you know, letting us do our thing.
You know, just kind of getting clear on what is the problem, and then kind of thinking through the ideas and how to solve for them.
The industry that was assigned to our team was healthcare and wellness. My initial reaction was, there's so many different aspects of healthcare and wellness, whether it be physically, mentally, or financially. So that was my initial thought.
Have you guys seen what you're gonna be scored against?
No, ma'am.
That is probably a good thing to get started on.
How you present is really gonna be a big factor. Because, I mean, you can come up with a brilliant idea, right? But if you can't present it well, you know, who's gonna really receive it? Okay.
So, what was the first thing that came to your mind when you heard that our industry is technology?
Well, one of my first thoughts was, Hallelujah, thank you, Jesus.
What made me do Moguls in the Making is I wanted to get better at confidence and public speaking.
You know, throw out any ideas. It can sound crazy. It can sound like impossible. But if you all create a safe space where, you know, opinions and thoughts won't get judged or made fun of as a group, right, that's really where that innovation can come through.
And the mentors aren't the only resource that students have at their disposal. Each panel and workshop throughout the weekend will add valuable context as to why economic mobility is so key and teach valuable business and life skills that students can use with them during this competition and beyond.
All right, I'm here with Man of Omega, Margie Martin. What's up, good brother? Just like a noob today, first and foremost.
Hey, man, you know I got to read.
But
I'm here representing Thurgood Marshall College Fund. We excited, we engaged.
So we are here for Moguls in the Making.
Yes.
Right? What are some important characteristics and traits that these kids are gonna have to display this week in order to come out successful?
These students need to possess like the curiosity, right? And so they just wrapped up their human-centered design workshop, and they got a lot of the design think and those elements, right? They're getting to understand themselves. And we're gonna see how that transform into obviously the rest of the day, Saturday and into Sunday pitch day, they got to be energized. They got to be ready. But I think these workshops that they're getting today definitely transcends into that.
Some of those words of wisdom will come from the Mogul Made alumni panel, where students will hear from Moguls in the Making alumni on what it takes to be successful in the Moguls competition and business overall.
My name is Joshua Weaver, a recent graduate of North Carolina A&T, and I am the most recent winner of Moguls in the Making competition.
I say feed into the pressure. Don't give into it, but feed into it and own it. Once you tell yourself you're nervous and you accept the fact that you're nervous, the nerves kind of just go away.
The type of qualities that I gained from this experience, the soft skills that I gained, how to build and be a part of a team, those skills helped me to be the leader that I am now in my role.
Before y'all leave, just get 5 people's numbers. See how they're doing. Have an interpersonal conversation with them. And then you'll never know where the relationship will go from there, because you'll never know what you'll be doing in a year or two from now.
You're already a mogul.
Yep.
Absolutely.
And one of the most important things that we can ask these students is, why is this competition so important to them? So I'm gonna take a couple of minutes, talk to some of the participants, and figure out what exactly is their why.
I wanted to give exposure to Tuskegee. It's a really small school that really doesn't get the exposure that I feel that it deserves. Sure.
This competition can like bring so much value just to my career, and also like to like my like development skills.
Right.
It was meant for us to be here. It's such a great event for all HBCUs all across the board, but I got a vouch from mine right now.
So
I've done other competitions, but nothing like this, to be honest.
Yeah.
I'm just glad to be here.
Yeah.
I mean, it's really important just overall networking purposes, like I said, and just be here to have fun. That's what it's really all about.
The students have been afforded a full day of valuable learning and interactive activities. But even though the sun has gone down for many of the teams, their day has just begun.
In my mind about like food banks and stuff like that. So like
the industry that we got assigned was food and nutrition. And it definitely makes us think outside of the box and just overall think harder and bring us to something that we're not used to.
Let's say you see these buildings right here, literally the lights are on right now. Mm-hmm. Nobody's in that building.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Which means it's taking power from a house nearby that could use it.
So my team and I, we were given the industry of energy, and with that, we were really nervous because it requires a lot of research, and it gave us a lot of anxiety.
Think about, we're talking about economic mobility, right? Mm-hmm. Think about what happens to a community when they get a retail store.
Right.
Like before and after a Target.
When y'all present, if one of these execs asks y'all a question about housing, it would be so dope for when you all to respond and be like, well, in my case, I have experience. You see what I'm saying?
With day 3 of 4 just around the corner, each team is realizing they will have to go above and beyond their scheduled ideation hours to prepare a successful pitch.
Yeah. Should I be doing work when I get back to work?
No.
You should really don't be working.
Oh yeah, we definitely stayed up till about, you know, 1:15, 1:20. I stayed up a little bit later than that. That energy, that drive, I just felt it and I had to keep going. I looked up, the time just flew by.
I'm just so excited. I want to win. I feel like we can definitely win. Like, we literally will win.
Next time on Moguls in the Making.
So it's day 3 of Moguls in the Making, and our students have been working extremely hard.
I believe the pressure is really getting to them right now.
I'm definitely anxious.
We are tired, but every time that I want to fall asleep, I'm like, you could sleep after we win.
There's so much pressure on us. Pressure creates diamonds, so I'm excited to see how far we can go.
Oh,
Thank you.